Materials and components in our everyday lives are constantly subject to wear mechanisms. Hydrogen plays a critical role in this process. Its presence can cause various types of material damage during both production and operation. Material changes caused by hydrogen primarily affect components under high operational loads, such as aircraft landing gear. The stress from these loads can create micro cracks in the material. Hydrogen, produced through corrosion, can then diffuse into the material, weakening its structure and causing embrittlement. This can result in component failure during use, something that must be avoided under all circumstances. Fasteners like screws and bolts are also vulnerable to hydrogen embrittlement during production. Hydrogen generated in cleaning and separation processes can diffuse into the material, increasing the risk of failure. The interaction of hydrogen exposure, material properties, and mechanical stress can lead to critical breakdowns during operation. To mitigate these risks, targeted measures to reduce hydrogen ingress and optimize material selection are essential. Hydrogen pipes and pipelines are similarly at risk of damage during operation. Pressurized molecular hydrogen can penetrate the material, accumulate within its atomic lattice, and reduce fatigue strength. This can cause leaks or failures under mechanical stress or pressure loads. One type of damage, known as hydrogen-induced stress corrosion cracking, involves the formation and propagation of fine cracks along grain boundaries or dislocations. These cracks grow under stress and can ultimately cause sudden component failure. The H2DTN measuring station is used to study this phenomenon. Various materials in the form of C-rings can be tested under different electrolytes. These C-rings are mechanically stressed inside an electrolyte container with the resulting deformation energy recorded. Micro notches can be added to simulate notch effects, while reference electrodes enable precise monitoring of electrochemical phase interface reactions. Another form of damage, internal hydrogen embrittlement, can cause fine cracks under stress, leading to brittle component failure, often without prior plastic deformation. Three measurement methods are available for analyzing materials and processes. The tension bending test measures deformation energy in C-ring specimens with high precision. By creating an embrittlement index, materials can be evaluated before and after each step, detecting behavior changes within minutes. Electrochemical permeation measurement can be carried out using the H2PU measuring station, which employs a double-cell setup to record the hydrogen produced on the reaction side. This system measures hydrogen permeation through a workpiece or membrane and assesses the barrier effect of protective layer systems reproducibly. Thermal desorption spectrometry determines hydrogen content in materials by thermally releasing trapped hydrogen and analyzing it with a mass spectrometer. Comparing hydrogen levels across process steps provides a complete history of material exposure. A third type of damage, operational material fatigue, occurs when pressurized molecular hydrogen causes premature fatigue, which under load can result in cracks or leaks. Two methods are available to analyze this. The H2DTM measuring station enables fatigue testing under a hydrogen atmosphere. Specimens in C-ring form are subjected to cyclic or static loads, revealing fatigue strength under pressurized hydrogen and identifying critical material conditions. Permeation measurements under pressure are carried out using a double cell setup and the differential pressure method to measure hydrogen permeation through materials, analyzing the barrier effect of coatings. Hydrogen-induced stress corrosion cracking can be examined through operational stress tests, which assess the effect of different electrolytes on components under load. Combining stress testing, permeation measurement, and thermal desorption spectrometry enables the reproducible analysis of production-related embrittlement risks. The analysis of materials under a real compressed hydrogen atmosphere enables the qualification of various materials for reliable use in the hydrogen economy. By combining the measurement methods of iChem analytics, an in-depth understanding of hydrogen embrittlement can be achieved, preventing critical damage and cost-intensive product faults, ensuring optimal performance across applications.